Hello everyone, this is Shaista, currently doing MBA from IIM Trichy. So today we are going to discuss about COVID-19 issue and its effect on Indian economy and how it has, how it's going to impact further in future. So let's get started. So currently major businesses, they are in a fear of constant crashing of their business and how the financial market is going to react because of this. And this is a very serious issue. So first, let's understand what is the current status. So more than 75,000 people have been died because of this, and globally, and the death toll, and the people of getting testing positive is increasing, and it's currently 14.5 lakh somewhere. So it's a very serious issue. So let's look into how it is affecting sector by sector and what has been done and what can be done. So first is the electronic industry. So we all know India is strongly dependent on China for importing electronic goods, and is importing more than 55% of electronic goods from China. Because of this issue, this has dropped to 40%. Not only that, we are also the third largest exporter of raw materials and minerals to China, and because of this, this has also been affected, and this has affected in our trade deficit largely. So this is something that is seriously hit. A second industry is pharmaceutical industry. So currently pharmaceutical industry is in need, because we are working on producing, working on the drug for COVID-19, which is currently on trial. So apart from this, we are majorly dependent on importing API, just actively pharmaceutical ingredients from China, and because of this issue, this is also getting seriously hit. So how it is affecting is that the basic drugs that are being produced in India, like penicillin or for cold and flu, all these require API. So since we are not able to get it from China, we the basic prices are like hiking, and it is hiking currently around somewhere 55%. So that is also something that is getting affected. So what can be done is that for the electronics industry, the Indian government is introducing indigenous goods, and to promote Indian based electronics, so as to not to depend on one single market. Similarly, in pharmaceutical industry, what we can do is we can encourage all these small pharmaceutical industries who are not given a chance because of this, and we can try to get API from some other country which is safe, or not till now, but later on, so as to see. So the next industry that is seriously hit is the travel and tourism industry. India is a well-known country for travel and tourism because of its rich cultural and historical heritage. And not to say, this is seriously hit because many visas are getting declined because of travel, and we all know travel is the main reason for getting COVID-19 inside India. So this is something that needs to be completely eradicated or stopped currently. So because of this, the entire supply chain of travel industry is completely collapsed, like from the hotels, the restaurants, or the dealers, the tourist guides, everything. So entire industry is being collapsed because of this, and this is one industry which is seriously hit. So the next industry is the aviation industry. We could see more than 90 domestic flights and more than 600 international flights have been cancelled because to prevent this issue, and also many people are getting laid off every day. So this is something that we cannot avoid currently, but for the safety, this has to be done. And so these are the industries that are getting affected, and few measures that we could do. So now what policymakers are telling and what we can do to combat these issues are that we can implement on targeting fiscal deficit, and also policy rate cuts, something that can be done. Apart from that, if widening the fiscal stimulus, something. So these are a few measures that can be done. Apart from that, what government has done till now is that government has increased the take-to-pay GST tax, that is for current 2018 to 19 fiscal year. It has increased till June 31st, 2020. Also, it has implemented on introducing e-voicing till October 1, 2020. So these are a few measures that government has taken from their side. This issue is really something that is very difficult right now, but what we can do as citizens from our side is that we can follow personal hygiene and maintain social distancing. Two things that is really important that we need to follow currently so as to avoid this issue. So we have faced a lot of issues, and this is something this can also be faced if we stay together as one country united. If we follow government guidelines, we can surely combat this. The economic issues, the economic repercussions are very high. But if we do these things within 2-3 months, this can be really combated, and we can get back to our normal economy, and we can lead a normal life. So I urge everyone to stay safe inside their home, follow social distancing and personal hygiene for your health. Thank you.